Aaron Burnett Out Front, weeknights at 7, only on CNN.
Always quick to attack his foes, since shortly after the Newtown shootings, Wayne LaPierre has been everywhere, talking up gun ownership, talking down gun laws, and promoting his solution to school shootings, as he did on Meet the Press.
If it's crazy to call for putting police and armed security in our school to protect our children, then call me crazy.
Many critics have called him just that in his 22 years as leader of the NRA. The former conservative activist and lobbyist is well known for what his opponents often call inflammatory statements. In a 1995 fundraising letter, for example, he called federal agents enforcing gun laws, quote, jackbooted thugs. In 2000, he implied President Clinton was an accessory to murder, allowing gun deaths to mount up to build public support for gun control. And after the Columbine High School killings, he told Congress the NRA's members were being unfairly blamed.
There's somehow a reckless societal pathogen, a mighty extremist empire opposed to safety, caution, and reason. That's a cruel and dangerous lie.
When Arizona Congresswoman Gabby Giffords was shot, LaPierre said it happened not far from a school, a gun-free zone. And once again, he lit into his foes.
It didn't make any difference. Their laws don't work. Their lies don't ring true. And if Tucson tells us anything at all, it tells us this. Government failed.
And now, even with Newtown still close at hand, he says it is gun control advocates who are endangering America.
We believe in our right to defend ourselves and our families with semi-automatic firearms technology.
Still, for all his bluster, LaPierre has turned the NRA into a political juggernaut, amassing more than 4 million members and pouring $16 million into political races last year alone, making politicians fear not only his bark, but also his bite.